contrast paint we developed as a completely new way of painting miniatures that allows people a one coat approach that gives you both the colour and the shading all in one go.
Anytime we release any new painting products, it's always really interesting to see where you can go with it and what you can do with it. Anyone who's looking to paint an army quickly, anyone who's new to painting and just starting off that journey, they can kind of lean on the contrast paints. But at the same time, I think contrast paint is something that can kind of grow with you as you go through that journey and can kind of sit alongside you no matter what level of painting you're doing.
We always try and develop paints that allow people to be proud of the work that they've put in, to be proud of the results that they're getting. And with contrast, at the beginning of the process, we were looking at new ways in which we could achieve that. We then took the ideas that we came up with and started talking to chemists in paint labs. Once we've got that brief across to the chemists and they've started to develop some products, it's a whole lot of testing. One of the things we realised really early on is you can't test the paint on a sheet of paper or on the miniature that's still on the frame. We have to assemble the miniatures and we have to paint them using the process that, that a painter would use at home. During this process, we think we have assembled, undercoated and painted 12 entire chapters worth of Space Marines.
One thing that we tried out with contrast paints early on was using them almost as vibrancy booster in other paints, mixing them with the regular paints. So adding a really vibrant splash of contrast into your existing layer paint to just boost the color of it works really well. We've also used contrast paint through an airbrush to tint kind of large areas and give like really thin glaze layers over other colors. Because of the translucency of the pigment in some of these contrast paints, it works great with the metallics. It kind of mats them down a little bit, but not enough to kill the reflective nature of the metallic paint. If you've got your painting techniques down and you know how you like to paint, there's still ways to implement that into whatever you're kind of doing. It's not here to replace something, it's here to add on to everything that's already there, which just kind of makes everything stronger.
I think everybody's really just starting to get to grips with the possibilities that contrast paint offers. It is a different approach to miniature painting. From my perspective, having developed the paint, one of the most exciting things is to actually see what people do with it when they start to play with it at home.
As soon as it hits and gets into people's hands, it kind of takes on a life of its own. And that's when you really start seeing how everyone's kind of implementing it, slightly different depending on their painting style. And you'll see probably hundreds of different ways of using it, slightly different, and you can kind of pick up the gems. I'm really looking forward to seeing what people do.
My own experience of using these paints through the testing and development process is it has now completely changed my own personal approach to painting miniatures, painting armies. It has speeded me up and it has given me lots of different directions to go in. So my experience has been great. Hopefully everyone else's will be too.